didn't give me 20, man.
No.
Why not?
You owe me, Mark, Leah, Paul, and even the government money. You have a problem.
I ain't gonna pay when I buy. Listen, I ain't gonna pay when I buy next.
You say so all the time. You know that you in debt. You need to learn to manage your spending and get out the debt.
Barbados is in a situation like this, which is why debt management is as important as managing your spending. Countries contract debt in order to help finance fiscal deficits. When financing cannot be completely covered by government taxes, they have to seek alternative funding from loans and securities.
With respect to public debt management, what is first important is the fiscal deficit. Over the last fiscal year, government had a fiscal deficit in the region of 6.9%. That deficit has to be financed, and government uses various sources to finance this fiscal deficit by both you can finance it by borrowing, or you can finance it by borrowing for domestic sources, for example the national insurance scheme, or you can use the sale of your public shares or resources, or you can even use taxation and so on. And this has to be balanced. Normally the best way for a small open economy like Barbados with a fixed exchange rate regime to finance a fiscal deficit is to be able to borrow and at the same time generate foreign exchange. But this then adds to the external debt, the total debt stock, which then is a problem.
To help with debt management, a few safeguards can be put in place.
So what is required is a strategy, also known as public debt management strategy, to allow governments to design a methodology for addressing what terms and conditions should these loans be contracted under. To whom should we enter contracts? Should it be on the domestic market, or should it be on the foreign market? On the foreign market implies that we have to deal with the fluctuation in fixed and floating exchange rate, which can also inflate our existing debt profile. So debt management strategies are definitely required. These can help to boost the creditworthiness of the government as well.
Okay, cool. But I guess this applies generally to the options countries have available to them when considering how to manage their debt. But what specifically has Barbados done?
In 2011, the government of Barbados established a debt management unit and two committees. One, the Debt Advisory Committee, which looks at policy formulation, and the other, the Technical Debt Advisory Committee, which looks at the analytical aspect of debt. Now, in general, debt management objectives are designed in such a way to enable governments to meet their financial obligation at the lowest possible cost and the lowest possible risk, not only in the medium term, but in the long term, in such a manner that there's no significant stress on the economy.
An individual and a country is one in the same when it comes to debt management. Both can create debt and may not know how to manage it. However, if the right strategies and guidelines are followed, debt management would be a whole lot easier. Until next time, I am Alicia Bascom, and this has been It Matters Fiscally. Did you know that about 50 years ago, the Jamaican dollar was more valuable than the US dollar?
Wait. I don't think I'm hearing right. What's that you said? Explain it to me, please.
In our small island of Bimshire, unlike Jamaica, we figured out how to protect our valued dollar. Yeah.